Good morning, everyone. Thanks for watching News to Go. Out and about in northwest Arkansas, early temperatures are in the 40s and 50s. By the lunch hour, nice warm up with sunshine. Temperature will be close to 70. The high today for northwest Arkansas will stay in the low 70s. And if you're in the River Valley, the day is just as nice. Plenty of sunshine. By the lunch hour, you'll be moving into the low 70s. A little breezy in the afternoon. The high tops out at 76. Hope you can have a great day.
All right, thanks, Laura. Well, a Springdale man accused of stabbing a mechanic to death will be in court this morning. Police say Juan Lopez Perez showed up to the auto shop with a hunting knife back in February. They say Lopez Perez killed the mechanic when he was not happy with the service. He's being charged with capital murder. Officials say that an Arkansas State Prison inmate has died of an apparent hanging. The Arkansas Department of Correction says that the man was found last night with a bedsheet twisted around his neck. Officials say his death is under investigation, but that it's believed to be a suicide. The man was serving a 4-year prison sentence for terroristic threatening in Jackson County. A bridge in one city is closed today and will be for a while. 4029's Yugoche Adloka in Prairie Grove with what this means for your drive.
Yeah, city leaders tell us that this bridge actually will be closed and shut down for at least the next 4 to 6 months, depending on winter weather. Now, it's actually located here just down the road from where we are on Illinois Chapel Road, also known as Park Street. Now, drivers can use the detour from Highway 62 on Butler Road. The city has also installed a footbridge in case of emergencies. And we heard from neighbors, and they tell us that there's a little bit of flooding out here, so they're hoping that the construction, once it's done here on the bridge, will help relieve that problem. Reporting in Prairie Grove, Yugoche Adloka, 4029 News.
The fire department is planning on placing a vehicle on the east side of the creek to speed up response times. That's your News to Go, everyone. Thanks for watching. I'm Joshua Cole.